So today we are going to CRGH, Fertility Clinic in Canterbury, Kent. We've driven, starting very early this morning from London, and we're going to meet their team and some of their patients who are going to talk about how their struggles have affected them, tips for getting through fertility treatment, and yeah, any anxieties that people have, and really behind the scenes to find out what goes on, which will be super interesting, and I'm really looking forward to today. Okay, we're going for a little tour of the clinic.
So, living kitchen there.
And then here, we've got one of the consulting rooms where I'm going to be having my scan. And bloods.
Reception.
Let's go and look upstairs. How gorgeous Canterbury is. We've just been to the cathedral. It's absolutely beautiful building as well.
Hello.
Oh, hi, Sue. How are you?
Very well. I've switched to a medical one. There we go.
I'm consultant gynecologist and fertility specialist, and work in this field for many years as a consultant, more than 20 years. I do care for my patients, and I care about the outcome. And that's the reason I choose to work for CRGH.
Okay, so do you have any experiences with fertility or know personal stories of people who have struggled?
Do have personal experience myself. So we did struggle, my husband and myself, to have children. Of course, a long time ago.
What would you say is the most challenging part of your job?
All of us, we want to give them, you know, a family. They want to have children. So sometimes when you say to them, your results indicate, for example, you going through a premature ovarian failure, you will not be able to have your own children, you need to be very close to them, which I'm proud to say I'm very close to my patients always, and trying to be there at every step when they start the treatment and before.
Excellent, thank you very much.
To see how things have changed since I last had a scan at CRGH yeah. 6 years ago.
Is this good enough?
Yeah, that's comfy, thank you.
Yeah, you and I've put the jelly now, so you may feel a bit cold when I'm doing the scan.
Okay. So what are we going to see on the screen today?
So Eloise, I'm going to take your uterus and the ovaries. So I'm going to take the endometrial lining, just relax the legs then.
Excellent. And I'm going to explain to you every step. That's your bladder.
So roughly how many days is your period?
About four.
4.8. I'm going to measure the uterus too, yeah? You see, that's the fundus of the uterus. This is the cervix here, so that's the body of the uterus. I'm just going to measure all this now. I'm just going through to see. Yeah, and then look at your ovaries.
So when someone comes in for an initial consultation, they have those blood tests, they come for a scan, and what you've mentioned what you're looking for in an initial scan. What would be the next steps after that?
So once we have these results, of course, we like to see also the semen analysis of the partner, if the person is in a relationship, then we will set up a follow-up consultation, we review the results, and we make a treatment plan with the patient.
Great, thank you so much. I've just had my scan, and then Nurse Sue is going to take my bloods, which we're going to be offering as part of an upcoming giveaway, where someone has the opportunity to receive a free scan, like I just had, and also bloods to find out where their fertility is at. So I'm having my blood taken, but I have very deep veins, so we're going to have a go and see whether we're lucky. We're not
okay, well, I'm the clinic nurse
here. My role here is to work in support with Ms. Goumenou and to meet and greet the patients, try my best to put them at their ease, explain what we're going to do.
So having been a fertility patient myself, I know that about the highs and the lows, and I'm a serial warrior, very, very anxious. How do you support patients here who are struggling with the enormity that is fertility treatment?
Not overwhelming with information is quite important. They need to, as Ms. Goumenou said, they need to be fully aware and to understand at each stage, not to try to see all the process through at the beginning. Mainly I got into clinic work because I had an interest in actually vaccination. And for years I conducted vaccination consultations. I very much like the one-to-one patient contact that allows.
So you must get to know the patients really well.
Yes, we do. We do. We do follow their journey, and we do maintain as close a relationship as we possibly can.
Okay, so we're going to go and chat with Suki, who's the assistant manager at CRGH, and find out a bit more about what it's like for patients and in the clinic.
You don't realise until kind of I came into this work how much it can affect so many people as well, without even knowing about it, because obviously it's quite a private thing as well.
Yeah.
That they want to go through.
Yeah, and I guess it makes you more aware of people sort of seeing your fertile health, doesn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. This is not something you often think about until you're kind of faced with it. I often speak to the patients as well and organise anything that they'll need in terms of like appointments or information and things like that, and go from there really.
So if people are looking at for treatment and then mm-hmm. they're interested in working with, say, CRGH Canterbury as mm-hmm. a satellite clinic, do you guys help with the like closing the gaps in terms of what appointments need to be where you need to be, schedules, that kind
Absolutely.
Of thing?
Yeah, so communication is a massive thing, especially when you're based in two separate places with one person or a couple, whichever, and so you don't want them to kind of be going here when they really should be there, or like going there when they should be there, and just to have all of the information, it's going to be like a massive journey that they go through.
Name it Gray, but
take a seat.
Yeah, because it can get quite intense, but you just have to think of the final goal.
Yeah, exactly.
Through it.
Do you have any advice for people who might be looking into treatment, not knowing where to start? Any tips for people starting treatment?
Me personally, my advice would definitely be to get as much knowledge about it as you can, so that nothing is going to be a surprise, because it is invasive.
Have either family or a couple of close friends to talk to, which is really good.
Obviously we live local to Broadstairs, or close to Canterbury.
Yeah,
and
a lot
so
of the
for
clinics
us,
are obviously London based. And at that time I was just like, I can't be going up to London like every couple of days, scans and things every day.
We wanted to go with like the best, to give us the best chance to have a baby. And the CRGH came up as the top for success rates. Overall and in older women.
I did loads of research into it, and A, their results were very strong, and then at the time Ms. Goumenou told us that they're looking at creating a Canterbury clinic.
Yeah. Drive here just for like a 10 minute blood test would have been like a 2 hour drive to London, which would have been expensive as well, and then a 2 hour drive back, it would have taken like most of the day to have just a blood test or a scan done. And that was one of our big reasons we picked CRGH.